I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. And we're doing something different today. We are outside and we're going to talk about an app that I have just kind of fallen in love with and use all the time that's called Waze. And it's a social media GPS system. So we're going to get in my car, going to take a drive and show you how Waze can be used to help people with disabilities when it comes to driving.
So here we are in my car. We've got my iPhone mounted to the dash. And I'm going to start up the Waze app here. And when you start it up, the first thing it does is figure out where you are. And then it starts to show you information about traffic. And we can see right here that nearby on Keystone Avenue, it's got a yellow thing going on there because traffic's running a little bit slow. And what I'm going to do is tell it that I want us to navigate over to the local CVS store because there's one just real close here.
Let's go.
And it's going to give me some directions.
Turn right on Willow Brook Parkway.
I'm going to tell it, let's go and let's drive. And you'll notice that it puts my little red car there on the map and it draws a purple line that shows me the route that I'm going to take to get over to CVS. And it's going to take us out of the office park here and give me some turn-by-turn directions. At the bottom, you'll notice that it's given me the estimated time it's going to take, about 2 minutes to get there, that we're going to get there at about 3:24 p.m. and that it's about 0.4 miles for us to do this. And we'll get some directions here as we go. It's telling me my speed so that I can kind of check against my speedometer and get some verification of the speed that I'm driving. And I'm trying not to break the speed limit here. And the reason this is a good assistive technology app is it's really helpful for teen drivers with disabilities who are learning to drive and need some help with navigation.
Turn right on Willow Brook Parkway.
It might also be very helpful for people who are older and need some verification with directions. It also has the ability to allow the driver to provide real-time driving
information. Turn left on North Keystone Avenue, and turn right on East 46th Street.
And receive real-time driving information. So if I see a traffic jam, or if I see something like a pothole in the road, I can simply reach up here and report whatever information that I would like. Whether there's a police officer, I can report accidents, I can report gas prices, and those are gonna let other Waze users know some of the hazards. So that if I'm driving along, I might see that there's a traffic jam up ahead, and it might tell me, hey, we're gonna reroute your drive here based on the fact that there's a traffic jam ahead. The other thing that I like about it is it allows you to send an ETA to a loved one, so that if you want somebody to know when you're gonna make it there, you can. And I'll put us back on the navigation screen here since we're ready to drive. And you can see that it shows on the right, we're coming up on the CVS store, and it's showing where a photo can be added. Sometimes...
Turn right on East 46th Street.
Sometimes it'll show you a picture that kind of verifies the address or a photograph of the building so that you know that you're pulling up on the place that you kind of expect. The other thing that's interesting about this from an assistive technology perspective is young people, little kiddos, might be interested in following along while you drive because it does point out points of interest and it gives you information about the area in which you're driving. So anyway, Waze, W-A-Z-E, is a really great app if you're learning to drive, trying to communicate with the drivers and the people in your life that you love, or if you just want to know what's happening in the neighborhood while you're driving through. So I'm going to run into CVS and get a snack or something kind of cool. And that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.